Hello, I'm Justin with Liquid Web. Firewalld is a useful utility for managing firewall rules on a Linux server and often offers a more concise syntax than its counterpart, IP tables. In this tutorial, we will be walking through an introduction to Firewalld. Before we get started, I will mention I am working as the root user on a Liquid Web self-managed Ubuntu 20.04 server. All commands referenced in this tutorial are available in the video description. This tutorial assumes you have Firewalld installed and enabled. One other thing to mention, any port referenced in this tutorial should be replaced with the port you intend to open. To get started, we will cover adding TCP and UDP ports. firewall-cmd-permanent-add-port=22/TCP adds port 22 for TCP. firewall-cmd-permanent-add-port=53/UDP adds port 53 for UDP. Removing a port is just as simple. firewall-cmd-permanent-remove-port=53-UDP. It is also possible to add services to the firewall as well. Run the following command to open the default port for SSH. firewall-cmd-permanent-add-service=SSH. This warning is normal because SSH is already enabled on this server. Removing a service requires the same syntax, just replace add with remove. firewall-cmd-permanent-remove-service=mysql. MySQL isn't enabled on this server, so the warning is also expected. To whitelist an IP, run firewall-cmd-permanent-add-source=, followed by the IP to whitelist. Whitelisting a range of IPs is identical, but the source provided would be an IP range in CIDR notation. To remove a whitelisted IP or range, run firewall-cmd-permanent-remove-source=, followed by the IP or range to remove. Blocking an IP address or range of IP addresses requires a rich rule, which is a bit more like an IP tables command. firewall-cmd-permanent-add-rich-rule=, open double quote, rule, family equals, open single quote, IPv4, close single quote, source address equals, followed by the IP or range to block, followed by reject. To remove a rich rule, you must specify the whole rich rule to remove. Copy the rich rule we created in the last command, then enter firewall-cmd-permanent-remove-rich-rule=, and paste the rich rule in. The last and most important piece is to ensure that the changes are saved by running firewall-cmd-reload. To verify rules are in place, run the command firewall-cmd-list-all. That's it! You now know how to use Firewalld to configure aspects of the firewall on your system. Thanks for watching. For more information, visit our knowledge base at liquidweb.com/kb or our YouTube channel at youtube.com/user/liquidwebinc.